Hi, I'm Sue Greenwald with the Empowered Light Holistic Expo. Our next expo is September 6th through 8th in Oaks, Pennsylvania, which is right outside of Philadelphia. I'm here today with Charles Ziese, and I hope I said your last name correctly, who is with Only PVC Pyramids. Charles is going to be talking Saturday morning about pyramids, sacred geometry, and healing. Hi, Charles. How are you?
I'm doing great, Sue. How about you?
I'm doing amazing, but I am dying of curiosity to know more about what cool thing you're sitting in.
And well, well, a lot of it is due to you, Sue. You introduced me to this Zoom technology, and what I realized was that I could put a background with a green screen behind me, and the picture that I'm sitting in is actually the interior of the large pyramid that's built inside, or just outside of Moscow. So it looks like literally I'm sitting inside the pyramid. It's pretty cool. Now, the white pipes that you see here actually is one of my pyramids that I'm sitting inside of as I sit at my desk. So I'm kind of getting a dual effect here, but one's for real, one's just a background. But
well, it is the ultimately cool backdrop for sure. And tell us, before we get talking, tell us a little bit about your experience sitting in the pyramid that you are, the white PVC pyramid that you'll have at the expo. When you first sat in the pyramid, what was your experience? And then what made you continue to sit in that?
Well, I mean, one thing that happened to me from the outset, I was able to lose a lot of weight, and that was a tremendous benefit to me. And I attribute a lot of that to the energy field that the pyramid establishes wherever you put it. I put it inside my bedroom because that seems to be the best place when you're sleeping to have your body, you know, rejuvenate and regenerate. But, you know, I've also started to extensively meditate inside the pyramid over the last year or so. And once I got the sacred geometry of these pyramids perfected earlier this year, it's really made a huge difference in my ability to manifest my intentions. So I've had just tremendous results with it. Since I put the pyramid in my bedroom 3 years ago, I haven't had even an inkling of illness. I mean, not a sniffle, nothing. Aches and pains that I used to have. I broke my ankle about 10 years ago, and I didn't realize it that for a long time I was compensating with my ankle, and so it was starting to produce some aches and pains in my right knee, because that's the way when you compensate, those things happen. But since I've started sitting under the pyramid, had it in my room, you know, all those aches and pains have gone as well. So I'm living testimony that the research that was done in Russia on these pyramids is real.
So let me ask a lot of questions. How many hours a day do you currently sit in your pyramid?
Well, I try to meditate at least for half an hour in the morning. And then, you know, if I'm good, I get another half an hour at the end of the day. But again, it's in my bedroom. So the energy field that it puts out, you know, affects the energy throughout the room. And, you know, many people actually who are more sensitive can feel it. People, there's a doctor in Michigan, for example, and he's been telling me we're going to be doing an interview with him in a couple of weeks, a couple of days, actually. When he moves, when he's downstairs, he can feel the energy from it upstairs. So, I mean, it's really enormous. And depending upon your sensitivity to the energy,
right,
you'll feel it
right
quite a ways.
So you do not have the pyramid over your bed. It's in a
No.
separate area of the bedroom. So you're sleeping on the bed, and then you'll go over and physically sit inside the
That's
pyramid.
Right. That's right. And this pyramid is, you know, it's not, it wasn't meant, it wasn't designed to let you sit in it, but the geometry of it itself, as you can see, makes it very easy to sit inside of. So those people who want to meditate, you know, you can, I make a small version where you can do seated meditation only, but I'm sitting in what's the medium pyramid. You can get a bit larger one as well, but the medium and the large pyramid lets you actually sit in a chair. The large one, you can actually get a pretty comfortable chair to sit in. I have a Poang chair from IKEA, which is real comfortable, that I sit in when I meditate. So it's nice and comfortable.
Excellent. And you'll be demonstrating these at the expo, so anyone that physically goes there can go and try your pyramid out.
Absolutely. And one thing I want to let the people know, I didn't realize this until the last expo. It is free to come try these. Many, many people came and said, oh, are you charging for this? No, I don't charge for you to sit in the pyramid. So come on in, sit down, tell me what you think. But it's all absolutely free.
Yeah, that's fabulous. It's a fabulous test run and you can't beat the deal, right?
That's right. That's right. The price is right.
So let's talk a little bit about your talk. It's Saturday morning, September 7th at 10:30 in the Evolve Room. And it's really regarding Russian pyramids, sacred geometry, and the healing energy that these pyramids generate.
That's right.
That's what you'll be discussing. Do you want to elaborate a little bit on that?
Yeah. I have changed up a little bit of the presentation orientation because of some new research that I've done. I'm going to be reviewing the sacred geometry, how I came up with the sacred geometry of the Russian pyramids. I'm going to go over some research that I discussed briefly at the last meeting that a gentleman named Marshall Lefferts has done in a field of study called cosmometry. And what he shows is that this angle, this very angle that the pyramids are made of, can be found in nature in any number of respects. And he calls this angle the phi scaling angle. So we find that the Russians, you know, I came at it from their torsion physics and found the geometry this way. Marshall has found it in nature. But most importantly, in the last 6 weeks or so, I was on Richard Hoagland's show June 30th. He wasn't feeling well that evening, but he called in with a very, very poignant question. And he said, well, are there any other examples of this geometry that maybe mankind has made and that we find every in our everyday life? And I said, well, you know, Richard, I really haven't looked at that, but I'll start looking into it. Well, that's going to be the second half of the presentation. I don't want to give it all away, but this geometry is literally hiding in plain sight. And so I'm going to be showing the people who come to the talk where this geometry has been hiding for thousands of years. There are ancient buildings throughout the world that contain this geometry. You're going to find this geometry in both the Eastern and Western cultures, and you're going to find that it's present in our contemporary world as well. So it's really exciting information, and I think groundbreaking information for those people who are interested in pyramids.
And I think that too, that as time goes on, our science will bring out more and more the pyramids that are existing that have this technology in it and how it works a little bit and where the locations are. I know that a lot of the sites have been kept quiet. So I think we're going to be seeing a lot more of that as time, passes.
Well, I'll give a little bit of a hint about this, but some of the ancient Hindu temples incorporate this geometry. And I was at a very small retreat last weekend where I happened to meet the head of the Pyramid Spiritual Societies movement, which is the largest movement really in the world devoted to pyramid meditation. And it's headed up by a gentleman named Brahmarshi Patriji. And Patriji's asked me to come to India in October.
That's incredibly exciting.
Oh, this is going to be fascinating. Wow. Because they build pyramids that seat 6,000 to 8,000 people. Now, they've been using the Giza geometry, but I don't think they were aware until last week that this geometry of the Russian pyramids actually matches the Hindu temples. So Anyway, it's going to be a fascinating trip, and I can't wait to, when I come back next year, I'll be able to talk about the experiences on that trip to India.
That's amazing. That's an incredible trip. And for those that don't know, the geometry of a Russian pyramid is different than, say, the Egyptian pyramid that we think of. It's a steeper angle. It's a taller
angle. That's right.
So,
Yeah. What we found in my research is, as you say, as you can see, the Russian pyramid is more like this, where the Giza pyramid is less sloped like this. Right. Well, the angle right here that I'm making with at the top, that's called the apex angle of the Giza pyramid, is exactly to the third decimal point the slant angle, which is the side angle of the Russian pyramid. Now that can't be an accident, and I'm not going to give away all of my talk, but there's some ancient Egyptian information that I'll also be imparting that shows this very geometry pyramid was known about in Egypt thousands of years ago as well.
Of course it was.
Of course it was.
Now,
we're just rediscovering. That's all.
Yeah, we're rediscovering what the ancients already knew and what has been either forgotten or swept under the rug. So it's very exciting.
And part of the talk is going to be about how this geometry, when you see it hiding in plain sight, has been swept
under the rug. Right. So if I remember correctly, you were, we'll call it a regular person. You're an average person, if you will. I think you were an engineer of some sort.
I was an investment banker.
Oh, okay.
Well, I don't know if that makes me average or normal, but.
It's the same thing. Right. But you were a business person.
That's right.
All right. And so tell me how you got started with the Russian pyramids.
Well, you know, that all started with David Wilcock about 3 years ago. He did a 10-part series on the Russian pyramids on his wisdom teaching series on Gaia TV. He'd previously had some chapters in his book, The Synchronicity Key. And so, you know, there were little bits and pieces, but it was really that 10-part series. I saw the science. I was a biology major in college. And so I'm always still drawn first to the science. Because when I see science, I figure, well, all right, I'm going to spend some time. And when I, at the end of the series, David mentioned a website that was going to have these for sale as kits. And I went to the website and they said, sorry, David's wrong. We don't have kits to sell. So I was a little disappointed and started to say, well, I want to build one of these myself. And one thing led to another. And that's right. Where I got started.
And then you, it's like a passion for you now, because I know that when we've talked, you are extremely excited about it. And I mean, the discoveries are just going to keep coming.
Well, that's right. I mean, a year ago, I mentioned the show on Richard Hoagland, Laura London, who interviewed me. We met about a year ago at the Global Pyramid Conference in Chicago. And, you know, I was brand new. I just started making my pyramids, and she came up and she had a great question for me. She said, how come your pyramids give off so much more energy than the Giza pyramids do? And all I could say was, well, I know there's research to back it up, but I really can't tell you why, because I didn't know the sacred geometry. So that's kind of how I got started.
Right.
Laura was really asked the right question at the right time. And she said, well, And when I couldn't answer, I said, well, I have to figure this out. And so that's how I got on the thing of trying to figure out the sacred geometry. I figured it out. And now Richard asked me the same question about seeing this in the world, and it's everywhere. So people ask the right question. Sometimes that's all you need to get going.
That's true. And I've got to say how excited I am that you sell the kits, because everyone says they're going to build their own pyramid, but I know it's not that hard, but it's doing it. It's getting the materials, cutting it, the right angles. So just having, you know, your company available where you can easily purchase the pyramid is a no-brainer.
Well, I certainly think so. We've put in a lot of time and effort, R&D, to get this right. Since we were at your expo the last time, we've had a number of fits and starts to try to get our pipes and fittings to fit properly. I don't need to go into it, but we've unfortunately had to discontinue the clear pyramids that we showed in the last at the last expo. But the white and black work perfectly now, and so we're moving forward with that. And I might also add, Sue, you know, this is not to take away from my own business, because I do this research. I put it out for free, and so, you know, I need to be supported somewhere or another, and that's by selling the kits. But I did recently do a video to show people who really don't have the economic means to buy even one of my now lower priced by far pyramids, how to build your own pyramid with parts you can get at Home Depot. I give the links, the measurements, the SKU numbers. Cost you $30. So
wow.
The key thing that I want people to understand is there's no one on the planet who, at least and hopefully, that can't afford a pyramid if they're willing to put in the time and effort to follow the instructions in that video to get one. Now, is it going to be as pretty as mine? No, but it's going to be functional and it's going to work. And so for those of you who are do-it-yourselfers, I have that on the website. It's just called How to Build Your Own Russian Pyramid for around $30. And obviously, if you'd like something that's already built and you don't have to mess around with having to figure out how to cut the pipe and do all that stuff and buy the parts, you know, that's where my kits come in. And I would say, since we were at your expo, the prices of the pyramids, I've redesigned the pyramids quite a bit. And so the prices have come down dramatically. This white medium pyramid is now under $200. Wow. So it's very reasonably priced. And of course, the larger one is going to be a little bit more, about $20 more. But the way we have been able to do that, and I'd like to talk about this briefly, Lisa Richards, who was with me at the last expo, is going to be there once again. Lisa is doing custom capstones. I've redesigned the top of these pyramids now to where I don't provide a capstone with the base pyramid. We connect it with a zip tie, a clear zip tie at the top. But if you want a custom capstone, Lisa's going to be there at the expo to talk to you about those. I'm going to, if you don't mind, I'm going to pick one up because these are just beautiful things that she's putting together. And you can see on the bottom, there are holes that are custom cut to where, you know, the four holes of the pyramid will fit in. We've redesigned this. It's a lot sturdier and safer than it was, you know, in the past. So she will also do consults for folks to determine certain minerals, gemstones, crystals, and the like that can be put into the capstone to optimize the pyramid experience for any individual.
I love that, because that was my next question. And my question was going to be like, can you embellish these with your own crystals and things? And
yeah.
The answer is, of course, yes. Now, with your capstone, you've made it easy.
And that's right.
Yeah, you've made it easy. And of course, somebody that has the crystals can embellish the pyramid even more.
That's right. And I do have as an option for the pyramids, I'll put high crystalline quartz sand into the base pipes of the pyramid as well, which also enhances the energy field.
Right.
So that's an option that I put in. If you want a capstone, you just order from Lisa right there on the website.
Right. Excellent. I know, I think I told you this last time when we were in Bosnia, seeing the Bosnian pyramids, we all talked about making our own pyramid, just like what you've done. And not one of us lifted a finger when we got home. We were so excited. We talked about it for hours and did nothing. So you made it easy. All you need to do is, you know, basically click and pay, you know?
That's right. And that's about as hard as it is to put them together now, too. It's real simple. You can put this pyramid together in under 5 minutes. It's really not hard at all anymore because we really worked on making this simple and functional. So, and inexpensive.
Yes. Now tell us again, how long did it take you to lose, let's say, the 80 pounds that you lost through sitting in the pyramid?
Like it took about 8 to 9 months.
Okay.
It wasn't a dramatic weight loss, but it just kept coming off. I was doing all the right things before. I was eating well. I was drinking structured water. I was meditating. I was, you know, basically doing the right stuff, but it just wasn't coming off very fast. And as soon as I got the energy field, you know, cleaned up in my bedroom, that seemed to be the key, because then it just started to melt off easily.
Right. Okay. So basically it was very subtle. And again, if you've watched the David Wilcock videos, you know that certain materials are not conducive to our energetic field, such as plastic And what are most of our clothes and much of our houses made of nowadays? Plastic.
Sure. That's bad.
So there's certain things that are not conducive to our energetic fields. So basically, the pyramid will heal your energy field. And it might be subtle, but it's constantly working in the background.
That's right. That's exactly right. And that's the best way to put it. There's even research that the Russians have done that indicate that once you have established the energy field with a pyramid in a particular location, that you can actually take the pyramid away and it'll stay. Now, I don't know if it'll stay forever, but it will stay for an extended period of time. So this really is, it's kind of like a whirlpool. If you think of a pyramid, if you turn it upside down and think of it like a funnel, and putting water in it, is once you get the water stirring in the right direction, it's going to keep spinning for quite a while. So it is, it's something, I think it takes a little while for the energy field to maximize once you set the pyramid up. But once it's going, it really makes a tremendous difference in your home. I mean, when I walk into the house, I feel good energy in my home. And when I walk into other folks' houses, I can just tell a difference, you know. I think people experience the pyramids, find that. And I know when they were at the expo, earlier this year, that everybody who sat under it said that they could feel a tremendous
difference. Right. I agree. And so it's just a very subtle way of healing the energetic field. Of course, if you're more active and you sit in the pyramids longer and meditate or whatever, the benefits will be exponentially increased. Well, have you done any cool experiments by putting any other items in the pyramid to see how they've compared to an item on the outside world, like say a seed, a glass of water, things like that? Have you done anything like that yourself?
Well, one example in agriculture, we duplicated the results of the Russian research. We had two identical raised planters out in the backyard, and we put a pyramid in one and left the other one the way it was. Same soil, same plants, same everything. And the plants under the pyramid grew at least twice as fast. So, I mean, that's a given. One of the things that we've done that I think it should be interesting for the viewers, though, is distance healing. I mean, we've had a couple of videos I've done recently. Lisa is a distance healer, and another friend of mine in Omaha, Nebraska, and Francis, she does reconnective healing. And they've both done numerous distance healings, not just with me, but I mean with other people as well, and the results are just magnified when the use of the pyramid. So, and of course that correlates with what I've experienced when I put out an intention inside the pyramid. It just manifests. It whatever I'm asking for, it just flows right in.
You know, does the distance healer sit inside the pyramid while they do their session?
Very good question. And from the reconnective healing side of it, now Eric Pearl tells them apparently not to use any sort of gadgetry or whatever. So she has done hers where it's been the patient or the client who's been under the pyramid.
All right.
Lisa, she sits under the pyramid. Now, what's interesting is I just shipped Anne a pyramid herself. She didn't have one. She had bought one for her sister, so I sent her one. And she just got it yesterday, so she's going to start doing some distance healings where both she and the other party are going to be using the pyramids and see if they get any effect. But it doesn't seem to matter. One way or the other, the pyramid makes a big difference.
You should have them document their research. I mean, a lot of it is hard to measure healing.
It is.
Mm-hmm. You could measure, let's say, two identically grow like a seed or a plant that's grown, or two bouquets that you purchase, one in the pyramid, one outside. You can measure the, like in this case, the corruption of the flowers or the decay of the flowers.
I did a video last year, and it's on the YouTube page, where I took a plate of fresh fruits and vegetables, put one under the pyramid and one outside. And once again, just very traumatic. I mean, the stuff under the pyramid was much better preserved at the end of the 10 days than the other stuff, which was rotting. So, we've done that and it all works. So, you know, it's nice when you can actually replicate the science that you're talking about and know that it really works. So, it's fascinating.
It really is fascinating. And like I said, it's subtle. You don't actually have to do anything actively. Although if you do sit in consciously to the pyramid and do your intentions or your meditations, it will be stronger. But
absolutely,
even if you just have it in your, you know, environment, it's going to increase the energy. Now, what happens when we all have that and every home has a pyramid and every office has a pyramid in it and the energy gets better, 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 better? I wonder what would happen then.
Well, let's hope that the consciousness of our planet will rise. That's the case. I am living proof. I was not as nice a person as I am now. I mean, yeah, I was not fun to be around sometimes. 5 years ago, you know, so it's made me at peace. And I mean, I think again, that's documented by the Russian research. They've taken salt and put it under a big pyramid, distributed it throughout their prison populations in like 20 different prisons throughout Russia. And every one of the wardens said, it's like somebody changed out the prisoners because there's no more violence.
Yeah.
We can't figure it out. So yes, it's going to raise the consciousness and the vibration of the world. The more we get this type of energy in every home, any number of people that I admire, Dr. Ibrahim Karim, who does biogeometry, Dr. Golod, who builds the pyramids in Russia. I mean, they all say if we had a pyramid in every home, it would transform society. And
exactly.
I truly believe it would.
Exactly.
I mean, the healthcare industry doesn't make a cent off of me except for the Medicare company who gets my Advantage plan, because I never use it because I don't get sick and they still get their money. So, but you get the idea. Healthcare costs would drop dramatically, as would, I think, a whole raft of social ills like depression, violent behavior, and so forth. Absolutely.
I totally agree. So anyone that does come to the expo that's watching this, please go and try one of these pyramids. Just sit in it and see if you notice anything. Considering purchasing one or building one yourself, like Charles said, $30 worth of materials, a little bit more time and effort. And yeah. But just think of the possibilities. And I didn't tell you this, as we were talking about the healing energy, a hummingbird was just looking in my window.
So good for them. Well, they know something good's going on.
Yeah, they know it. So Charles, anything else you want to say before we wrap up?
No, that's about it. I'm looking forward to seeing everybody at the expo, and hope you'll have some time on Saturday to come listen to the talk. And I'm certainly willing and happy to answer every question. And remember, it's free to come try the pyramids.
Excellent. So basically, Charles is talking Saturday morning, September 7th, 2019, at 10:30 in the Evolve Room. It is included with your general admission ticket. And then you can also go over and sit in his pyramid and talk with him and ask as many questions as you like. Thanks so much for your time, Charles. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Have a great day.
Talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.